I have seen Feast, and I gotta say, as a new dog owner, I got a little choked up. It's definitely sad. So, I have a Yorkie poo. So,
I have
he's
wiener dogs.
Very nice.
Disney already had some wiener dogs in their history, so wanted a new dog.
Nice. So, that was the reason why you chose Winston to be Boston Terrier?
In our particular style, it was very flat and graphic and simple, so we needed a dog that had two-tone pattern, so when it turned, you can see it turning. And then something that was small, so we could rise him up to the table, and then a breed that hadn't been in Disney before. So you wanted to be able to look at the dog just as a drawing and identify it as Disney, but not with any other film that we've ever done.
So you used the animation technique Meander that was used with Paper Man. So it'd been about 2 years since that was released. What upgrades, I guess, were you able to, or improvements were you able to add to this film that Paper Man couldn't?
We made it a lot more efficient. We cut down the amount of time it took to actually do it by, I don't know, massively, 80%, just to be able to make the software more usable and more kind of friendly to what we're using it for. And we used it in color. We didn't use it in color last time. There was red. But,
and we used it differently on this short. We used it to define the interior of Winston as opposed to the edges on Paper Man.
Yeah.
So that was just another way we're sort of turning the tool on its head and playing with it differently.
Yeah.
For me, like line work, exterior sometimes is, it could possibly be redundant if you're just doing like graphic shapes that overlap and you can already tell the difference between them. So we were very efficient with where we put the line to make sure that it absolutely had to be there to make the shot clear.
So tell me about how you came to the unique look, because like you said, there's not harsh, crisp lines in the animation. It's almost grainy in a way. So how did you come to that?
Yeah, Jeff Turley, our production designer, he does amazing flat artwork, and I've always thought that his design and his sensibilities just needed to be on screen as pure as possible. So my promise to him was, we're going to put your artwork on screen exactly as you produce it. So the beautiful design and shot design and set design of every frame is Jeff designing it by hands himself. And
what's so brilliant about it is he sort of gives everything a torn edge. So it has this feeling of a very handmade short, like you want to go crawl in there and curl up with Winston and share nachos. And it doesn't have that hard look that CG can sometimes have.
Yeah.
Animation is handmade in one way or another. Even the biggest CG films are all technically pretty handmade. But we did a lot of stuff. Instead of making things simulated and real, we did a lot of stuff that was just kind of designed and simple.
So one of my favorite moments was the big Super Bowl celebration. So how did that scene come about?
That was kind of always in there in some form. I knew I wanted this initial sort of romance between the guy and his dog. It needed to hit something. It needed to hit some kind of level of excitement. And it seemed like flipping the table and food in the air should be something. And then the idea that a dog would have been here so much that he knows that when the announcer is getting crazy, that's going to happen, seemed like a fun thing to let the audience be a little bit smart about it and ahead of the short for a second. And it was always in there in some way. Just where it was placed changed a little bit.
I never got to thank you for the ice cream scene, because I've always loved the fact that it's the man who goes to the fridge and pigs out on ice cream.
We do that sometimes.
Thank you.
Yeah.
So food was a big, big important part of this film. So sometimes food can look very unappetizing with photography. And so what did you do to make it appealing with the style that you had chosen?
We had a food stylist come in and talk about what made food attractive when they photograph it. And it's really all about seeing each ingredient clearly and knowing what exactly is in that food. So we made sure that you see like the layers and everything. And that you, if you want it to be appetizing, that you light it in white light and then use a shallow depth of focus. So a lot of the cinematography side of it was inspired by those kind of, that type of photography, that shallow depth of field and the white light, using white light when things are meant to be happy.
The other thing we did is we always chose really iconic food, because some of the shots are 20 frames long. You need to know exactly what Winston's eating. It can't be some kind of mush. You need to know it's pizza, it's nachos, etc. And that made us choose very, very simple iconic food that you recognize immediately.
Well, I definitely want that fry that was on the ground at the beginning.
Salty crinkle cut. Yeah. That was a very specific choice, because it's got to be it's got to be the right thing on the ground right away. So very iconic stuff.
So tell me about the timeline for this film, because you originally were working on Big Hero 6 as co-head of animation and then got selected for the Disney Shorts program for this first iteration. So how, timeline from start to finish, what was it like working together?
It was awesome to work with Christina again. We had worked on Paper Man. Zach is back there somewhere. We're working on Big Hero 6 together for about a year before Feast really got started. So, you know, I was animating Baymax a little bit, getting him figuring out what he's going to be. But I'm the kind of person who likes to just try things. And I thought it'd be fun to pitch to Lasseter. It seemed like a great experience. Like, you don't want to have an opportunity to do that and miss. So, and I got lucky, and he connected to the concepts, telling the story of a life over dinner.
And so from green light to release, well, to finish, 53 weeks.
Wow, that's awesome.
A bunch of story, and then 16 weeks of shot production, and a month of sound and music at the end.
Well, it's amazing. I definitely got choked up, so congratulations. And I'm excited that it's the first, you kind of paving the way for the new Disney Shorts program, so you did a great job.
It's so much fun that we're going to keep making them. It's like, it's great that there's a program to make this a tradition. I love it.
So, well, thank you.
Thanks. Thank you.